You know, some spiritual disciplines are necessary in order to grow in Christ. Welcome to today's DDRX. The prescription is check your choices. Deuteronomy 30:19, I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life that both you and your descendants may live. I want to look at John's disciples and Jesus' disciples. And here we see fasting and feasting. It's a choice. You know, some spiritual disciplines are necessary in order to grow in Christ. One of such spiritual disciplines is fasting, but it has to be done with the right motives. Fasting is not to be done to impress others. In Mark 2:15, the disciples of John and of the Pharisees were fasting. Then they came and said to him, "Why do the disciples of John and of the Pharisees fast, but your disciples do not fast?" And Mark 2:19-20, Jesus said to them, "Can the friends of the bridegroom fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom with them, they cannot fast. But the days will come when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, and then they will fast in those days." You know, this is the days that Jesus is talking about, you know, that the bridegroom will be taken away in this unprecedented and uncertain season. You can choose to fast or to feast. But let me tell you, fasting works. Jesus fasted to overcome the enemies. Paul fasted to overcome the enemies. Even the disciples, they got it. They fasted to overcome the enemies. You know, in Mark 9:29, Jesus told the disciple the secret. He said, "This kind can come out by nothing but prayer and fasting." This tells me there are some things that need prayer and fasting to overcome. Because this was a time that the disciples could not heal a small boy, you know, that was suffering from a demonic attack. And Jesus, by mere speaking, healed this boy. And the disciples came to him privately to find out the reason. And Jesus said, "This kind of miracle cannot happen unless you give yourself to fasting and praying." Fasting should not be a lost art in 21st century. You know, in Matthew 6:16-17, the Bible says, "Moreover, when you fast," you see, it's not if you fast. So fasting is one of the clearest taught doctrines in the Word of God, especially in times of crisis like this. We need to choose a fasted life. Thank you.